We lost two soldiers, then it all changed. Nah, literally, then it was all bling. We married mainstream, thought that it was all a fling. Then the white boy came and it was all the same. Suddenly, rap was backpacking in the cul-de-sacs with skull caps and sullen facts. A gangster rap tab, middle America, but little Erica. The parents gassed, Lindsay dropped it low, but really it was all a parent trap. Music hit the scene, ATL lit the fluid, a new black movement. From young jocks to Jeezy, young jocks of Wheezy.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get free RAM. Your computer will thank you later. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man. Today's a big day because, as we know, Tech N9ne has dropped his brand new album. So we are going to continue the journey of the one and only Tech N9ne. And not only that, we have a track with another legend, an idol of mine. I am talking about Wheezy F Baby. So today, it is time to do Tech N9ne, to do Lil Wayne, and make history with their song, Too Good. But before we go any further, I just want to make a quick announcement, guys. I saw a stat that over 70% of you who watch these videos are not subscribed. Do me a favor, watch this vid. If you like it, support the channel directly. Subscribe and notifications on. It helps boost me up in the algorithm, helps me to continue to grow, and to try to reach my goal of going full-time here on YouTube. But anyways, we know what we're here for. Lil Wayne, Tech N9ne. Step up to the plate. Let's see what you got. Ooh. Let's go.
One of the coolest to rep my sec. Only the foolish neglect projects.
I love this intro. This is such an album intro, isn't it? It's not like something you would hear on a single. You don't hear, you know, a bunch of a cappella singing in replacement of the instrumentation. I swear I can speak today, but Tech has already broken up my brain. I mean, it's just so cool. This has got to be Moo Moo Fresh. She's got such a smooth voice. And when she went up in her range, that was like an angel singing. And I love the humming. It just feels like it's taking you to church right now. And notice how nothing else is playing. Everything is vocal layers stacked on top of each other. Just set the tone and set the stage. And then boom. That bass all of a sudden kicks in. And then that subdued sort of rhythmic drum pattern starts to kick. And then here comes Tech. Lower. Drop down in the cadence. Man, the musicality to that one. Let's appreciate it one more time. Can we? Why not? Nice. This is dope. And get ready for the drop down.
One of the coolest to rep my sec. Ah. Only the foolish neglect projects. Coming from the newest and blessed by Tech. Clergy of Craig.
Blessed by Tech. Check my set. Like the multi-syllabance rhymes. This is what Tech is known for. He is a master technician with the rhyme schemes. We talked about it in the last rock feature. But here we go again. Tech at his best, man.
Foolish neglect projects. Coming from the newest and blessed by Tech. Clergy of craze, worthy of praise, like Anubis and wept while wet. Dismiss.
Wow. I mean, Tech, listen, you gotta know your history when you do Tech. You gotta know, like, philosophy. You gotta know pop culture references. You gotta know Egyptian references. We got Anubis here, right? The god of death. We also have wet while wet, which was, that was the Egyptian version of the god of war in warfare, wasn't it? So he's taking us down that darkness and that path with what he's doing. And again, these rhyme schemes, check this out. He's got a cool little internal condensed scheme, and then he's still got his external scheme that he kicks out at the end.
Clergy of craze, worthy of praise, like...
Clergy of craze, worthy of praise. So he's got that nice little four syllables internal scheme while he still has the da-da-da, that three-syllable end scheme on the end. One more time, I'll point this out.
Coming from the newest and blessed by Tech. Clergy of craze, worthy of praise, like Anubis and wept while wet.
Wet while wet. So he uses wet while wet, the Egyptian god's name, within the rhyme scheme of his three-syllable scheme. So he's got that nice little just internal punchy scheme with the clergy of praise and all that. And then he still carries on that triple scheme on the end. Man, everything just lights up when Tech starts writing a verse in terms of the rhymes and how they match up.
Clergy of craze, worthy of praise, like Anubis and wept while wet. Dismiss what I played at thee, Adamu could, must have wrong should. Slick spit from a hater see, all the crew stood of a...
Slick spit from a hater see? Wow, I mean, that's like poetry with the rhymes. Did I hear Damu as well? Hold up.
Praise worthy of praise like Anubis and wept while wet. Dismiss what I played at thee, Adamu could, must have wrong should. Slick...
Adamu could, what a wrong should. Damu, are we doing, we talking about bloods here? Like blood slang and language, like East Coast bloods? I think
wet
so.
While wet. Dismiss what I played at thee, Adamu could, must have wrong should. Slick spit from a hater see, all the crew stood of a strong wood. Miss dicks with the fate of tea, red I move hoods, bro, your song should.
Wow. I mean, he's just literally matching up the rhyme schemes again. Let's see if I can break this a little further.
Dismiss what I played at thee, Adamu could, must have wrong should. Slick spit from a hater see, all the crew.
Slick spit, hater see.
Stood of a strong wood.
Crew stood, strong wood. Wow, so that whole sentence and the way he sets up that structure, he's going to match that line for line. That's intricate. That's like an AA rhyme scheme, BB rhymes, and then CC rhymes. He's got three different rhyme schemes within that line that he is going to mirror as he follows through on it. That's insane.
Could, must have wrong should. Slick spit from a hater see, all the crew stood of a strong wood.
Crew stood, strong wood. So crew stood, ooh, ud, strong wood. So he takes those sounds and he matches those up on the ends of the scheme.
Mystics with the fate of tea.
And then he's got, at the beginning of the scheme, mystics, like this ick sound, this ick scheme he has at the beginning. And then A to E, like play to C, that sound he's got in the middle. So the ick sound at the beginning, the A to E sound in the middle, and then the on ud, on wood, those different sounds at the end. I'm trying to point it out without knowing all the lyrics and the shit that he's going to say, but just pay attention to this because he just lines it all up so well.
Slick spit from a hater see, all the crew stood of a strong wood. Miss dicks with the fate of tea, red I move hoods, bro, your song should.
Yeah, move hoods, song should. See how he matches that up to the beginning on that side? And then the miss sticks with the tea and like reading the tea leaves, like mysticism. Some people believe that you can read your tea leaves and tell your future with that. Man, I love the wordplay, but the rhyme schemes by Tech. Woo! Everything is rhyming.
Stood of a strong wood. Mystics with the fate of tea. Red, I move hoods, bro, your song should. Critics, what they say to me is that I'm too good for my own good. A lot of my people in circles around the hood, they treat my music like...
He did four lines of that exact same rhyme scheme, rhyming literally every single point of the sentence. That is insane. And he is too good for his own good at this point in time. So
Ticks,
true.
What they say to me is that I'm too good for my own good. A lot of my people in circles around the hood, they treat my music like a blondie. Too much emotion and too many cadences. They want you on the mic a zombie. Lyrically against a fickle listener.
They treat my lyrics like a blondie. I was trying to think of if I knew any slang for blondie. But I think what he's saying there, like around the hood, like treating it like a blondie, treating it like a white girl, right? Coming in because you don't really belong in the hood and in that culture. Like white girl meets the ghetto in that sense. Like he just stands out. Like they don't connect to it for whatever reason. They don't relate to it. And then now he's too good with his cadences, with his flows, with his changes, with everything he does. He feels like he's not getting the respect that he deserves. And this is a little bit of a shot at mainstream music and why Tech has never been mainstream and why he's been underground. He's like, they want me to rap like a zombie. You know, they don't want me to think about what I'm saying, to have these intricate schemes and the way that I do stuff, being too good for your own good, the theme of the song, I like it.
Too much emotion and too many cadences, they want you on the mic a zombie. Lyrically against the fickle listener, quick the pistol whip you like a Chansey. Then I step with a thicky like a Shanti, spit a web of witty quite a Nancy.
Wow, okay, pistol whip you like Chauncey, that is a Menace to Society reference when Kane didn't like Chauncey, you know, hitting on his girl, so Kane pistol whipped the shit out of him. Then we got Ashanti bars, thicky like Ashanti, right? Ashanti, the R&B singer, she was thick, but also, I think this goes even further, hold up. Asanzi? He did Asanzi, didn't he?
Too much emotion and too many cadences. They want you on the mic a zombie. Lyrically against the fickle listener, quick the pistol whip you like a Chansey. Then I step with a thicky like a Shanti. Spit a web of witty quite a Nancy. Then I step with a thicky like a Shanti. Spit a web of witty quite a Nancy.
Anansi, I thought it was Asanzi or Anansi. I don't know if I can get the name right. But anyways, that is African folklore. And that is like spit the web, like the intricate web that he's spinning, right? This web of words, but also like the way that he spins everything and gives it to you literally like a spider spinning it. And Anansi or Sansi. Ah, come on, Nox's brain. But anyways, that was a spider in West African folklore, which is also called like Ashanti tales. So not only do you have like Ashanti, the shout out to the singer, but also Ashanti in terms of the type of folklore. And then you have this spider who was known to be kind of like the Loki of West African sort of mythology. He was a trickster. And he even went up to the sky god and tricked him into having the sky god share his story so that he could then share those stories with the world. And then the series of tales and stories that he shares from the sky god comes from the spider. So again, the spider weaving the web. But man, again, with Tech, you got to know so much. The level of depth to this man's knowledge is crazy. Chansey, then I step with a thicky like a shanty. Spit a web of witty, quite a Nancy. If you spit ridiculous and raise the bar up. But don't want to reach it and want to see it. The moment I speak it, don't want to receive it. The one I'm alone at the time. You become so invisible to them. You hear how there's like a, it's a, I don't know, it's almost like a xylophone or something, like a just punching in the back of the mix that's matching, just matching every single syllabance hit that he does, and I love that. So he's got the rhythm here, and then he comes with a fast flow, then he mirrors that again, fast flow again, so much mirroring with the sequencing and schemes, and it's just, it's on another level rhythmically. Become so invisible to them, your name don't spark up. Opponent defeated, I'm only conceded. They don't compete. They turn and retreat. They running, I'm gunning for God. Rigorous fail. They running, I'm gunning for God. Ooh, he's conceded right now, and he's admitting, hey man, listen, they don't want to stay on my level. They can't keep up with me. So at this point, I'm too good for my own good. I'm firing at God. I'm reaching way up there. Spark up. Opponent defeated, I'm only conceded. They don't compete. They turn and retreat. They running, I'm gunning for God. Rigorous. Don't make it say the da. It's again, it's like a drummer. Tech takes his voice and turns it into drummer patterns. And it's like you play this and then you come up and he just punches words in between. And he's got the own sounds that he's locked in on. Oh, eat it. Oh, eat it. Oh, eat it. And he comes up and he punches those O sounds like the tone and the dome and all of those. It's so good, man. His vocal control. Don't spark up. Ready? I'm only conceded. They don't compete. They turn and retreat. They're running. I'm gonna forget. Rigorous fail when idols give it. Wicked as hell and pyro with it. Gibberish cells and I grow vicious. Nigga, this Dell and hieroglyphics. Too good at a thing. Dell the Homo sapien and his group Hieroglyphics. I love him paying homage there. Also, the hieroglyphic shouts out the Anubis lines that he used earlier and the Egyptian god lines. It's nice. Might be, I can't even do a versus with no, because I'm gonna. I want to know what that is. It wasn't a xylophone. I don't know where I got that from. It was a wooden block. It was a wooden block that was being played. And it's just got that tone way back in the mix. And it's so cool because they took that when he used it for that rhythm in the verse. And now they're applying it to the hook. What a wild hook, man. It's kind of like subdued. It puts you in like just false sense of peace and just being laid back. But then you have Tech coming through with these silky, smooth rhythms and faster flows when he wants. It's a just an interesting dynamic on the track. I'm just too good. That's smooth, man. What else can I do standing next to you but ruin your career? Exacerbate your fear. Ooh. Make it so you can't ever. Oh no, I just heard the lighter. I just heard the lighter. That means we got Tucci. Exacerbate your fear. Make it so you, yes, can't ever come back around. Let's go. I'm like two tray with the flu weight, talking shit and out of toothpaste, bitch. I didn't think Weezy was gonna come in with that faster sort of scheme. Too great, too weight. So he's got that double rhyme scheme, but he's just punching it so internal and so condensed and so fast with it. I was not ready for Weezy to attack the beat in that way. Let's go. Never come back around here. Ready? Great. I'm like two tray with the flu weight, talking shit. I'm like two tray with the flu weight. Two tray, the three, right? like shooting a tray, shooting a three in basketball. He's got the two tray, right? When he raises that with the flu weight, he's heavy with the weight, heavy with the artillery, but also 2-3 is the numbers of Michael Jordan. If you guys watch the Last Dance documentary, great Netflix series of Michael Jordan, one of his whips, infamously, everyone's like, what does 2-3 mean? Well, 2-3, that's his number, the great 23. And one of Michael Jordan's greatest games, game 5, I believe it was against the Utah Jazz, was the infamous flu game when he had the flu and he still just went in and just balled the hell out. So he's got the flu way, get it? Wayne is sick with it when he's dropping it, paying homage to Michael Jordan in his own way. Let's go.
Too good, no, I'm too great. I'm like 2-3 with the flu way. Talking shit and out of toothpaste. Big B's, Bobby Boucher. On my wrist, I got the skeleton.
Big B's, Bobby Boucher? We talking Waterboy, Adam Sandler? Big B's, Bobby Boucher. Let's go. Talking
shit and out of toothpaste. Big B's, Bobby Boucher.
Talking shit and out of toothpaste. I really love those lines. Those are like kind of those abstract lines you just got to think through for a second. Like Wheezy is just so known for, man. Because, right, wash your mouth out. If you're talking dirty, if you're talking shit, you got to wash it out. But he's out of toothpaste, so he can't wash his mouth out with all the shit that he's talking.
I'm too great. I'm like 2-3 with the flu weight. Talking shit and out of toothpaste. Big B's, Bobby Boucher. On my wrist, I got the skeleton. Richie with the see-through face. Drive the whip without the...
My wrist, I got the skeleton, like a skeleton watch, like a Hublot watch. Let's go. He's got that really, really expensive watch on his wrist. And then playing off of the skeleton, like the see-through face, like Richie. Is that a Lionel Richie bar? Because Lionel Richie had a bunch of plastic surgery done, like see-through face. Or is there something deeper than that, playing off of the skeleton and the see-through? I think that might be it, but if I'm missing something, you guys can comment down below.
I know I'm too great, I'm like 2-3 with the flu weight. Talking shit and out of toothpaste. Big B's, Bobby Boucher. On my wrist, I got the skeleton. Richie with the see-through face. Drive the whip without the toothpaste. Pregnant pistol, got a due date. I'm too good for my own.
Drive the whip without the toupee. The whip, oh my God, what a great line. And then, the line that really got me there was pistol pregnant. Got the due date, like it's time. It is your time, due date, but this time it's not giving life. It's taking the opposite of that.
Face, drive the whip without the toupee. Pregnant pistol, got a due date. I'm too good for my own good. I cross my heart, I knock on wood. I lost my heart, I found my foot. I stand my...
Cross my heart, hope to die. Stick a needle in my eye, you knock on wood, right? You do these little superstitious things for luck, obviously. I love the way he plays
too
on that.
Good for my own good. I cross my heart, I knock on wood. I lost my heart, I found my...
Oh my God. Wow. I can't even regurgitate that one, but that was dope as hell. I stand my ground, that ground I stood. Like I stood that ground up. I walk the walk, that ground is shook. Now when he walks, he's a monster. He's shaking the ground. It's earthquakes when he walks. He was almost knocked down, and he's taken that. He's transformed into a giant, into a beast on the track. I just love Wayne's just like how he takes his personal story and his personal struggles and just the way that he flips words and bends it and make you think about it and the poetry that he gives. He's just got such a unique way of writing and delivering his stuff, man. And obviously, I'm too good for my own good, like Tech said. I love those lines. So when you lost your heart, you found your foot. Your foot in order to stand on the solid ground. When he tried to cross his heart, he realized that he lost it. And also, that could be taken like a relationship. Like he's been crossed in a relationship and that he's lost his heart. Like he's rapped on no love before, but he somehow found a way to keep going.
I'm one of the bullets to rep my set. I don't do computers, but I sip tight tech. I don't do
I'm one of the bullets to rep my set. Now, Wheezy, infamously associated with the Bloods. What do Bloods do? They like to replace words like what's happening with bees, what's bracken. I'm one of the coolest. So replacing the C because that's more of a Crip thing. He replaces it with a B, one of the bullets. And then what was the Tech shout out? He sips, he doesn't do computers, but he sips high tech, right? Because high tech is a company that makes promethazine and lean that we know Wheezy likes to sip, but also like he's high tech relating to the computer technology, but also literally high tech. How you doing? I'm on this track. Nice trip.
I took that time I put inside these thoughts, and since this art, they gotta look. I'm one of the bullets to rep my set. I don't do computers, but I sip high tech. I don't do computers, but my chips like that. I don't do computers, but my shooters put a bullet wound in your apple. It look bit like Mac, just like that.
I wanted to stop it. I don't do computers, but my chips, like my computer chip, but my chips, my money is like that, what I'm stacking right now. But then he takes the computers one line further. He doesn't do it one line or two lines. He uses it for three completely different punchlines. And he takes the computers and flips it, put a hole in your apple, into your head. It looks bit like the Macintosh logo, like the Mac computer logo, which is taking a bite out of the apple, literally taking a bite out of your head when you get shot. Come on.
My shooters put Woo. A bullet wound in your apple. It look bit like Mac. Just like this, like that, my drip like split.
Or apple is an Adam's apple.
Yeah, apple. It look bit like Mac, just like this, like that, my drip like splat. With lips like that, she kiss my gat, just my black. Beat the beat up like this.
Oh, Wheezy. You naughty. She kissed my gat. It might go brat, like he's spitting with it, or other things might happen. We'll let your imagination wander there.
Black. With lips like that, she kiss my gat, just my black. Beat the beat up like this track, trying to fist fight back. When the producer heard this verse, it left his eye black. As my chef, I eat.
Fist fight back, his eye black. I love those rhyme schemes. And when the producer heard this beat, because he's fist fighting it, he's beating the shit out of this beat, literally playing off of the word beat, like he's beating it up, right? So it was so bad and he went so hard in it that he left the producer's eye black. Oh, that's a Wheezy one-liner. That is great, man.
When the producer heard this verse, it left his eye black. Woo! As my chef, I eat rappers, I like mine's prep. Still an icon, feeling like the only icon left. That's real shit,
I really like that line. He's just got a way of bending words, man. Still the ex-con, feeling like the only icon left. Love that. Just love the line, man. Pretty straightforward in terms of breaking it apart, but really good one.
Prep. Still an ex-con, feeling like the only icon left. That's real shit. I'm still a shit. I ain't white mine yet. The greatest of all time, and I got a lifetime left. Touch.
The greatest of all time, and I still got a lifetime left. Man, as Stevie would say, talk your shit, Wheezy.
I'm still good for my own good.
I love it, man. I love that when they take the production and they make it sound like super drowned out and it's like very subdued in the back of the mix, and then that bass just becomes more of the focus and it's just so gritty there. And just, yeah, it's a interesting combination on this beat, because again, like her voice and singing, you know, it's so suave and silky and smooth, and there's this beautifulness to it. But then you have like the ruggedness of Tech with the faster flows, and then the ruggedness of Wayne with the wordplay and the raps and the way that they bend things. Yeah, just man, this is cool. This is definitely a different pocket and a different vibe. I'm so glad that I got to just listen to two absolute legends rip apart the track together. Tech 9, Lil Wayne, you are Knoxville certified. So, if you guys liked today's video, if you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other Tech 9 tracks you want to see me do, Lil Wayne tracks, or if there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys, and respond as much as I can, so please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, if for some reason you're here at the end of this video, obviously you're enjoying the content, do me a favor, guys, support the channel directly, subscribe, notifications on. As always, this is your reminder to stay safe, stay positive. It's Knoxville. I'll catch you again. I'm out.